David Scott and Marilyn Jondle met when they were students at St. Olaf College in Minnesota. Scott and Marilyn were married shortly after graduating on April 21, 1973. Scott was in the ROTC and entered the Air Force, where he achieved the rank of captain. Marilyn loved working with her hands, knitting, sewing, and making soaps and assorted cheeses for her friends and family. Scott was honorably discharged from the Air Force in 1981, and in 1986 they moved to Silicon Valley, where Scott worked for Lockheed. He would make quite a bit of money, and the couple would adopt three sons. In 2000, with the giant nest egg at their disposal, the Jondles moved to Dallas, Oregon to open the Abundant Life Farm. On October 31, 2010, a water delivery man would be making his usual weekly delivery to the farm. When he didn't get a response to his knocking on the door, he walked around the side of the house and found the garage door open. He looked inside and saw a man slumped in a corner with his head bashed in and blood everywhere. He immediately called 911. When the Polk County Sheriff officers got to the farm, they found David Jondle dead in his garage with the apparent murder weapon nearby. It was a large scythe covered in blood. Upon further investigation into the rest of the home, they discovered Marilyn Jondle deceased in the kitchen. She was also covered in blood, lying face down with a gash in her head. Both of their credit cards were missing. While the two older Jondle boys had already moved away from the home to start their own lives, the youngest son, Andrew, who was 20 at this time, still lived at home. Police searched the farm, but he was nowhere to be found. They did, however, find a bloody pipe on the floor of the barn. Crime scene investigators and later an autopsy would reveal that David was attacked with both weapons. He was stabbed numerous times in the chest with the scythe and beaten in the head with the pipe. They found no defensive wounds on him, so they concluded that his attacker or attackers had surprised him. They further speculated that the positioning of Marilyn's body indicated that she most likely heard the disturbance from the garage. When she went to the door to investigate, that's where she was attacked with the pipe. She made it to the kitchen, where the attack eventually concluded with her death on the floor. The police began to search for Andrew, and they came across a police report that listed his name along with a lady named Cindy Lou Beck in a petty theft case. Beck was a 46-year-old mother of two teenage boys, and it was discovered that she had met Andrew while at a park with her sons. The two had struck up a conversation and began dating immediately. Neighbors told police that Andrew was over Cindy's apartment complex almost daily. Although the relationship seemed strange to everyone around them, the couple was apparently very much in love. Having been homeschooled and isolated on his farm for most of his life, Andrew started receiving the adult attention he had craved. Cindy felt alive because she was with a younger man. Andrew had decided to introduce his parents to Cindy. They disapproved of the considerable age gap between the couple. This caused a strain in the family dynamic and was also a significant burden on Cindy and Andrew's relationship. David Jondle tried to reason with Andrew to stop seeing Cindy, but he refused and moved in with her instead. A week before the murders, witnesses said they saw David talking to Andrew at Cindy's door for about an hour. He tried pleading with him to leave her and return home one final time. It did not work. Detectives went to Cindy Beck's house to question her and Andrew with that information. They saw David and Marilyn's credit cards on the living room table and arrested the couple upon entering the apartment. Cindy didn't give up any information during her interrogation, but Andrew told the detectives that he had killed his father in self-defense. He said that he and Cindy were 2 months behind in their rent and had called his father to discuss a loan. When he had gotten to the farm, the conversation turned south and his father attacked him, so he killed him to save his own life. The detectives didn't buy the story, and upon stating the apparent discrepancies, he finally told them the truth. He actually called his father from outside the garage and told him to come get him and bring him home. David agreed and went into the garage to get his truck. As soon as the garage doors opened, Andrew blindsided his father with a metal pipe. As his father crawled away, he grabbed the scythe and stabbed him multiple times. Marilyn had heard the commotion and opened the garage door. She began screaming and turned to run away. Andrew threw down the scythe, picked up the pipe, ran after her, and finally bludgeoned her to death. Andrew was charged with 2 counts of first-degree murder, and Cindy was charged with hindering prosecution during a murder investigation. The police felt like she may have had more of a role and decided to talk with her again. She kept the blame solely on Andrew and said she had nothing to do with it. They then returned to Andrew and told him that Cindy was blaming him entirely. He finally changed his story and told the detectives that Cindy was actually the mastermind. She had convinced him to murder his parents while she was in a trance-like state. She said she could see the future and saw them living happily together on the Jondles farm after his parents had been killed. The prosecution then upgraded her charges to match Andrew's. Andrew Thomas Jondle received a life sentence with a 50-year minimum. On July 29, 2011, he pleaded guilty to 2 counts of aggravated murder and 1 count of robbery. Cindy Lou Beck received a 20-year term. On August 31, 2011, she entered a no-contest plea to 2 counts of conspiracy to commit murder. In the years since the murders, the two remaining brothers have found it in their hearts to forgive Andrew.